Welcome, Henry.
I want your money, bastard. And all your valuables.
Cunt!
Oh, shit.
You fucking dumb. Jesus Christ.
Ow. Oh dear, did that hurt? To hell with you.
Thank you.
What now? Shall we take a walk?
You don't give up, do you?
Well, let me think. But probably not in the rain. We could both catch a fever. Pick me up when it turns nice again and we'll go for a stroll.
As her ladyship commands?
You jester.
What now? Shall we take a walk?
You don't give up, do you?
Well, let me think. I've got lots to do right now. But I'd love to...
As her lady...
You...
Thank you.
You can return home. It was hard work to convince them, so please don't get into trouble when you go back.
Thank you. I'd like to give you something, but I've got nothing, except if you're ever traveling by way of Neuhof, stop by and I'll show you something with the horses.
Hey!
Look where you're going.
Hey.
What now? Shall we take a walk?
You don't give up, do you?
Probably.
As her lady.
You just.
What now? Shall we take a walk?
It's getting too late now.
As her late.
What now?
You don't. And where would you care to go?
What if we took a stroll along the river?
Why not? That sounds lovely. Shall we go?
Let's go.
That was a good idea to go for a walk. Not that I don't like the mill, but you get tired of it, so I'm glad you took me out. I'd love to see the markets in Prague one day. Have you ever been to Prague?
No, I haven't. I have been in Kuttenberg, but Prague must be much bigger.
I've heard it's pretty smelly, though.
Yeah, so many people in one place. So many assholes.
That's disgusting. I'd love to listen to that young preacher, Jan Hus. They say he preaches in the common tongue. Everyone's talking about it.
I bet he's just handsome. That's why the women dote on him.
You're a right one. A preacher doesn't need good looks for people to listen to him.
And what about that fine fellow at St. James? I know full well why all the girls have started going to confession, and you have too, so don't give me any of that.
You scoundrel. Well, all right. I admit I find him handsome. But that doesn't make me a bad Christian.
I'd never dare to suggest such a thing.
Tell you what. Let's not dawdle. Last one is a slimy slug. What the hell are you doing? That was fun. Sit down here next to me, Hal. And what about you? I heard you're helping Sir Radzig.
Sir Radzig has me running in a few errands. I have to say, he always treats me well, and I make a wage.
So you've had your turn of luck. What's it like serving nobility?
I don't know. I suppose it's a job like any other.
I don't believe a word of it. If you ask me, you're loving every minute, and you don't want to make me envious.
Now then.
Oh, Henry, what am I going to do with you? Wandering the land, turning innocent girls' heads.
Not really. I'm spending my time hunting brigands and cumans around the woods, not chasing after wenches.
Just look after yourself, that's all. I dread to think of anything happening to you. But now I have to go.
Can I go with you?
I don't want to give anyone an excuse to gossip. Maybe another time.
Grrrr. Jesus Christ be praised.
I'd like to discuss the...
Well, we can... See now, I knew we'd come to an agreement.
Spades, forks, and axes, all you need to tame Mother Nature.
God be with you.
What are you doing, you murderer?
What on earth are you talking about?
I saw you robbing the corpse.
I was looking for signs of life, to see if I could help.
Uh-huh. And could you?
Unfortunately not anymore.
All right. I suppose you're not the guilty one after all.
I'm glad you saw sense. And what exactly were you doing here anyway?
What are you getting at?
You're carrying the murder weapon.
You won't prove it's the murder weapon, but I'll prove I know how to use it.
It'll be easier for you if you confess. I know what happened.
I won't leave criminals to roam the roads.
Oh, really? I'll tell you, if you try and pin something on me I haven't done...
You're the killer.
You can't go flinging around accusations against honest folk. I'm going to...
Damn! Thank you.
Have you lost something? Somebody help me!
Greater in the eyes of God than the poor fisherman who
radishes,
lives without
carrots and apples. That'll put a smile on your face.
Good day to you.
I'm looking for a fellow who lives here, but I don't know his name. Do you know anyone with a limp?
What would you want with him? Well, it's no skin off my nose. The bastard has a cottage on the edge of the village by the road to Rattai.
Move along, citizens. Move along. There's nothing to see here.
That's what you call nothing to see. I'd like to know what something to see looks like.
By the keys of St. Peter, this is all I need. We'll have to send word to Sir Hanush.
That might not be necessary.
Who are you?
I'm Henry of Scalitz, in the service of Hanush's Captain Bernard. I'm investigating the attack at Neuhof, and I think this could be related.
Well, I'm the bailiff of Auschwitz. And I say we don't want any of that kind of trouble around here. What makes you think this has anything to do with Neuhof?
One of the folk at the stud farm recognized someone from Auschwitz among the bandits.
We have no bandits or murderers around here.
Really? They say he had a limp?
Shit. Well, allow me to introduce you to Limpy Lubosch, or all that's left of him.
nothing's ever easy. I'll have to take a look around and ask a few more questions, if that's all right with you.
You can take this mess off my hands and welcome to it. As for what else there is to find out, I don't know. But look and ask all you like.
Who was Limpy Lubos?
A poor crofter and a scoundrel. Can't say I'm too surprised what happened to him. He kept company with all sorts of vermin. He was always getting into some kind of trouble. Punch-ups in the tavern and what have you.
How come he limped?
He got that from some villainy or brawl a long time ago.
Has he been up to anything suspicious lately?
I don't know. The last few days he didn't go anywhere. He was home the whole time. But he always kept everyone in the village at arm's length.
Did he have any kith or kin in the village?
None. A loner he was. I don't know the last time I saw him with anyone.
Do you happen to know where he was on the night of the Neuhof raid?
I've no idea. He kept his distance from other folk. So you never knew if he was away or holed up at home.
When did you find the body? And did anyone see anything?
Just now. And nobody saw or heard anything. I don't know how they could gut him like that without someone hearing him scream.
Another thing about Lubos. Above, they did a hell of a job on him. Must have been agony. How come no one heard anything? A bed? A bed? Nothing unusual.
Is it?
Oh, that weasel of a woman. Who knows what she's like? For all anyone knows, she might be some wild woman of the woods.
Not likely. We've already got all the wild woodland women at home ourselves. Excepting Vashek. He's got a she-dragon. good health to you.
Another thing about Luke.
My respects to you.
I've come in the name of Sir Hanush of Lipa. I'm investigating the massacre in Neuhof, and now a murder here as well. Can I ask you a few questions?
I don't know nothing about it, but ask all you want.
That man Lubos who was murdered, what was he like?
I didn't really know him. He kept to himself, even in the tavern.
Have you noticed anything suspicious recently?
Come to think of it, he was in church yesterday. He was even talking to the priest and went to confession. I was wondering what he was up to take to the faith all of a sudden. But I suppose no sin's too dark for God's mercy.
Do you know what Lubos was doing the day Neuhof was raided?
I was coming from the tavern very late that night, and I caught a glimpse of someone entering the village. He looked like he was in a hurry. It was only a shadow against the sky, but after what happened, I wouldn't wonder.
Do you know anyone Lubos used to spend time with? Relatives or friends?
Not with anyone from the village. He used to sit in the tavern next to us sometimes, but he never said much.
That's all. Thank you.
Good health to you.
I've come in the name of Sir Hanush of Lipa. I'm investigating the massacre in Neuhof, and now a murder here as well. Can I ask you a few questions?
Of course. Ask away.
That man Lubos who was murdered, what was he like?
He was a drunk who was always looking for a fight. Nobody liked him much. But I wouldn't wish an end like that on any man.
Have you noticed anything suspicious recently?
Well, now I think of it, I...
That's all. Thank you.
Jesus Christ be praised.
I'd like to learn to read.
You? You don't look like the makings of a priest or clerk. But why not? I've taught all sorts. Bear in mind, it won't be all that easy. You'll need plenty of time and a few groschen for my trouble.
All right. I don't want to waste time. We can get started. The sooner I master it, the better.
Very well. I will require some groschen from you, though, and set aside at least a couple of days so I can put you through your paces, if indeed time is of the essence.
Here are your groschen.
Then we may as well start.
He did break his vow, but better than to dishonor it here. May he follow his heart.
Wake up, lad. It's time we were getting on. So, let's see you read a bit. There's a book here on the table. Try to read it.
Will I manage?
You ought to be able to. It's a simple text. Come back once you've worked your way through it.
I've read the book.
Wonderful. So tell me, what have you learned?
There was something about some fellow and a goose.
Ah, well, the main thing is you've managed to read the book. The rest is just practice. Only through a careful reading will you uncover the real meaning of the text. No book is written on a mere whim and without purpose. Like I told you, books are valuable, and the words that you place in them ought to be no less so.
Does that mean that I can read, then?
Yes, you have the foundation. Remember, my boy, the pen is mightier than the sword. To fully learn your way around words will take a lot more reading yet. Now we'll move on to the second lesson, which will be much harder. Many books are written in Latin, the language of erudite and religious men. If you really want to be able to read, there's no getting away from Latin. There's a book on the table with some text. Read it and then come back. You need not understand it, but you should master the letters.
I only just managed the fable about the goose, and now you're asking me to tackle Latin.
You're a clever lad. You'll manage.
What the hell are you doing?
Hey! What is it?
Damn!
What the hell are you doing?
God be with you.
I read the page.
So tell me, Distrupule, what's written there?
Nullus est liber tam malus, ut non aliquae parte prosit.
Good heavens! Don't tell me you haven't had lessons before. Excellent! Well, there's nothing more I can teach you. Congratulations! You can go and be ordained right away.
Thank you, Domine. I'm feeling a lot wiser. I see you know how to wield a sword, Father. I wouldn't have expected that from a man of the cloth.
With a stick. I practiced with a stick. A reminder of my youth and days gone by, and it helps keep me in good form.
The blessings of our good Lord be with you, Father. I'm here in the name of Sir Hanish of Lipa, investigating the massacre at Neuhof, which seems to be connected to a murder here. Can I ask you a few questions?
It seems Sir Hanosh is employing children as investigators. But ask as you wish, boy. I hope this nasty business will be cleared up quickly.
Did you know Lubosch? What was he like?
Bit of a lost soul. Simple, rough fellow, but at heart I don't think he was such a bad person.
Did you notice anything suspicious recently?
My child, all sorts of suspicious things have been going on recently. People like Lubosch don't know what to do about it, and sometimes they do stupid things.
That's really not a lot of help to me, Father.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Do you know what Lubosch was doing on the day Neuhof was raided?
Unfortunately, I do know. And I'd like to help you with your investigation, but I can't.
What?
I'm bound by certain vows that forbid me to tell you.
Vows more important than catching dangerous murderers?
There are laws of God above the laws of man, son, and one of those is the sanctity of the confessional.
Father, surely you can't be serious. There must be situations in which you can make an exception.
There are things that apply always, no matter what the circumstances, and this is one of them.
But Lubosch is dead. You can't hurt him, but if you don't tell me, more innocent people may die.
If I told you, I would be betraying a vow that's a cornerstone of the Holy Church. If people believed the sanctity of the confessional couldn't be trusted, the consequences would be even worse than that.
Worse than the death of innocent Christians? Worse than the murderer escaping punishment?
No one escapes punishment.
Father, Lubosch was my only lead to the Neuhof raiders. Only he could tell me who was responsible for that massacre.
If I don't find out who it was, it will probably happen again. Surely you wouldn't want that.
I wouldn't. But I can't betray the sanctity of the confessional. I'll tell you what. Give me some time and I'll try to think up some way of helping you. Suppose we talk it over in the evening, in the tavern, over a cup of good wine. Maybe we'll come up with something.
All right. Thank you, Father.
Good day to you.
Have you got a bed for the night?
Certainly. For how long?
Just the one night.
Sure, but let's see your coin first. These are harsh times.
Here you are.
You all like it here. Like sleeping on a cloud, it is.